What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. I'm going to be pretty much, as you could tell probably from the title, this is going to be like the start of prep type vlog. I'm going to turn down the AC a little bit. So I'm about 6 weeks out, but I decided this is a good time to kind of like start a bit of the series for prep because I'm gonna get into the nitty gritty of things. I'm starting to like really tighten down on my diet. Training's getting more and more intense. Cardio's getting more intense. So I figured why not keep myself even more accountable by, you know, committing for these next 6 weeks to doing not daily uploads, but weekly uploads with the prep series leading up to the last week. We'll figure it out. I wanted to do daily uploads last week, but who knows? We'll see. I just might have to, you know, either stay super focused or might need a distraction. We'll find out later on. But my goal from here on out is to have one video a week of going on, or like pretty much updates for prep and everything like that. So pretty much these are my starting pictures, or at least this was from check-in this morning. So I'm still 6 weeks out, a little over 6 weeks out. Goal is to, you know, just do my best. I really don't have anything crazy in mind. Yeah, so if you're really interested with the prep series, make sure to like and comment. Let me know what you think and what you would want to see throughout this entire prep. Like what process you, like what processes you want to see, or processes. The things I'm doing to get lean, if you're curious about my training, my cardio, like leave a comment. Like the video, really helps support the algorithm. YouTube has not been pushing my videos recently. I guess because I took a massive hiatus for like forever. They don't want to, you know, push me back to the top. But we're getting back there, guys. So every like, every comment, it's really, really appreciated. So if you have any like questions or things you want to see throughout this prep, let me know in the comments. So today is a very rainy day in New Jersey. It's been the ghost of Hurricane Ian pretty much coming through. So this will be a little timestamp of when I got this video done. Hopefully I get it out soon. It's just been constant rainstorms for the past 3 days. But because I have an all-wheel drive Subaru, I get to have a lot of fun in the rain, snow, and everything like that. So I'm really excited for the colder weather to come back through. It's a lot of fun to drive the car like that. Just when road traction isn't great, you get to really see the performance come out. So enough about that. I'm pretty much going to be doing a little bit of errands today, but it makes errands a little more fun when you have a fun grocery getter, you know what I mean? So I'm going to be hitting a local grocery store, and then I might go shoot over to Sam's Club as well to pick up some bulk stuff. But I think that's all for now, so I'll talk to you in a little bit. Sorry, we're rolling. Oh, you can't reach it. I'm a loser. Oh, shit.
How's your morning cardio?
Honestly, I'm going to do it like that from now on. Like, yeah, it sucks waking up in the morning, and, like, I definitely, like, don't feel like doing it once. But once I get here, and when I take 8-2 a.m., the morning fat burner, it has, like, 150 milligrams of caffeine. But it hits so hard because you take it, it's two little capsules. And you take it, and the caffeine's just, boom, instantly in your bloodstream. So, like, it wakes me up and makes me feel euphoric. And then, like, literally getting here is so fucking easy after that. So, like, my morning routine, I know it sounds cancerous because, like, you're not supposed to wake up and then give yourself caffeine. But, like, it
everybody does.
Yeah, but, like, you're supposed to give yourself, like, 30 minutes to wake up. But, like, I think that's bullshit. Like, I genuinely think, like, that's just, like, Joe Schmo. Like, I gotta do more research on that because I was always told that. You know, you shouldn't be, it'll fuck with your circadian rhythm
on, like, naturally waking up. But, like, I don't naturally wake up anyways. I'm fucking rudely shaken from my sleep every morning, so.
Never naturally wake up. I have to set panic alarms so I don't sleep until 2 p.m.
Yeah, so.
I literally do all the time. I literally set alarms all, no, even if I don't have to wake up, I still set alarms because I'm too scared I'm going to sleep till, like, 2.
Yeah, that's what happens. Yeah, pretty much. And it's, you have, like, an onslaught of alarms just going off constantly. Yeah, so. It, I just think, honestly, having two caps right on the side of bed and you just pop them as soon as you wake up, not even, you don't even realize you popped them. You have to pop them so quick, you don't even remember if you popped them or not. So then you have to pop two more because you forgot if you popped them or not. And then you only realize like 30 minutes later, 45 minutes later, when it's fucking shaking your whole system with caffeine and energy and appetite suppressants.
The picture you put of me in rock bottom was so funny, and then I put on my story and some kid said I'm a fucking gremlin.
That's what it looked like. It was a good picture, man. You're just in there huddling in the corner by the charger. Yeah, your mattress is underneath the center carts with all the protein powder.
So this is usually my pre-workout meal. Normally, I would throw in like whey protein into my cream of wheat, but I'm starting to get to the point where like I kind of want to have a little more volume, so I'm going to be eating lean ground chicken. It's like 99.1% with my cream of wheat. And then I'm just gonna be adding a little bit of raw honey into the cream of wheat, about 28 grams of that. And this is pretty much a very easily digested, quick pre-workout meal. Dude, the pumps are insane. They only last like 20, 30 minutes at most at this point because carbs are so low. But like this big jolt of carbs, especially with the honey, like makes a massive difference. I'm just getting very hungry frequently, so I'd rather split up my meals a little bit because this definitely looks a lot bigger compared to just having this with some protein in it.
To be, what was it, 180 grams of rice? Is that what it was?
Yes.
All right. So I try my best to like meal prep as efficiently as possible. I'm literally at the end of my rice here, so I'm probably gonna have to cook more. Honestly, I don't wanna cook more tonight. This might be able to get like one more meal for tomorrow out of it, but at some point I'm gonna have to cook, but I try to like fill up massive tubs of this and massive tubs of this so that it just makes the eating process a lot easier. I was cooking all my meals for like the first like 3 weeks and it started getting exhausting. Especially when you're just really hungry and all you want to do is just throw food in your mouth. it makes it easier to adhere to a diet and just to like be consistent when you have the foods just already made. Because a lot of the times, you know, you come home and you know it's not ready to eat, and then you see foods that are ready to eat, like, you know, the Pop-Tarts or whatever, like, leftovers are in the fridge, or the cookies that are in my freezer, you know what I mean? And it kind of gets super tempting. So if you know you have food already prepared, it just makes it that much easier. So gonna be eating 180 grams of rice, 185 grams of lean protein, which I am choosing 99 1-ground chicken, and I think 190 grams of pineapple. Pineapple is great for digestion as well as it's a quick absorbing carb for post-workout. So it's essential that you prioritize carbohydrates around your training sessions. So pre, post, during, all perfect. This is probably my last carb meal. And then I'm gonna have two more meals that are just protein, a little bit of veggies and fats. But pretty reasonable.